The uproar over the Phillip Garrido kidnap case is leading to new questions tonight: how best to reform the parole system to better protect the public from sexual predators. Lawmakers were asking today how to fill the safety gaps in the system.
Garrido was improperly classified as a low-risk sex offender.
Admissions of parole agent mistakes in the handling of accused kidnapper Phillip Garrido were a strong focus today at this Capitol hearing.
We did give him an assessment. It was done incorrectly by that agent 10 years ago.
An incorrect assessment based in part on what corrections called sparse parole information from federal authorities. But today's panel had a much broader purpose in mind: how better to manage the state's large population of registered sex offenders.
Over time now, to see that we have 90,000 registered sex offenders, and the number's only going to continue to grow.
That's because California is one of only a handful of states that require lifetime registration. The state's aggressive approach has led to an unrealistic dependence, some critics say, on technology like GPS.
Would I rather have everybody on GPS? Absolutely. But I don't have the personnel to follow all of those dots.
To better manage the caseload at the state level, Corrections is boosting training.
We have greatly improved the supervision of parole agents, primarily through creating a field-level supervisor.
But most importantly, experts testified today, there's a renewed focus on assessing the risk level of offenders.
Well, that's the key, because a better assessment then gets the lower caseloads that focuses on the really bad people who are highly likely to recommit.
Now, Matthew Cate, the corrections secretary, said today that proper classification would have made a big difference in catching Garrido earlier as far as any disciplinary action against the parole agents involved in that case. He said it was a personnel matter and thus confidential.